The second design alternative I'm going to talk about mitigates exactly the problem that I mentioned earlier, and that is you want parallelism for accessing the database, because this is probably one of the slowest link in the whole processing of requests, because pulling in data from the database is going to take a lot of time, both in terms of I/O that has to be done through disks, as well as the network communication to pull in the data into the container where the processing needs to happen. And for that purpose, the structure that we have here is to push the business logic as part of this container, in which the servlet and the presentation logic was there. We add the business logic also and make it a three-tier software structure here: servlet, presentation logic, and business logic. And all of the data access is going to be done through what are called entity beans. As I mentioned earlier, entity beans have persistence characteristics. And in this particular example, I could think of the entity bean as representing one row of the database. So the data access object are implemented using a whole bunch of entity beans, and you can decide as a designer whether an entity bean is responsible for one row of a database or maybe for a set of rows of the database. But in any event, what we've done is we've taken the parallelism that is available in terms of data access to the database and encoded it through the entity bean so that there can be parallel access to the unit of granularity that we have in terms of database access. So the EJB container now contains these entity beans. So now, if a servlet that is serving a particular client needs to access some portion of the database, it can farm out parallel requests to these entity beans, to as many entity beans as it wants, and all of those entity beans can work in parallel on behalf of a single client and pull in the data that is needed and serve it up to the business logic so that the business logic can then do its thing. So we are reducing the time for data access by having this parallel structure and exploiting the available concurrency that may be there in terms of I/O performance. And also, even if there are parallel requests, those parallel requests may want access to the same portion of the database. If you think about the example I gave you of two different individuals wanting to make airline reservation for exactly the same dates with the same set of constraints, then there may be an opportunity for this entity bean to cluster the requests coming from several different end clients and amortize the access to the database server across several different clients that are temporally happening at the same time. And I mentioned entity beans usually are dealing with persistent state, which means that persistence has to be provided at some level to these entity beans. So that persistence has to be provided to the data access object at some level, which are using these entity beans. It could be done at the level of individual entity beans, which is called the bean-managed persistence. If the bean is managing the persistence needs of the data access object, then that is called bean-managed persistence. Or it could be that the container is providing that facility, in which case the persistence needs of the data access object is provided by the container, and that is called container-managed persistence. So these are two different design choices we can make in this structure. The structure is the same for the design alternative two. That is, we're using entity beans to implement data access objects, and we're deciding the granularity of the data access object based on the level of concurrency that we want in constructing this application service. But within that choice, there are two possibilities again in terms of how we provide persistence for the data access object, either by providing it in the entity bean itself or using the container service to provide that. So this once again points to opportunities for reuse of facilities that may be available. The same container managed persistence may be usable for different types of applications. One application may be an airline application. Another application may be a portal for hotel booking. All of those different applications may be able to reuse container managed persistence that's available in the structure. So the pros of this structure is, first of all, the concurrency, that you can actually exploit concurrency for data access for the same client in parallel or even across different clients by amortizing the data access that may be needed concurrently for similar services that are overlapping in terms of data usage. That's the good news. There's one con to this approach, and that is because we moved the business logic into the web container from the EJB container, it exposes the business logic to the outside network. We're not confined to the corporate network, but the business logic is exposed outside the corporate network in this design alternative. So all the data access code that used to be in the session bean in the previous structure that I talked about, all the data access code is now moved into this entity bean. That's how we get the parallelism in the fact that there are multiple entity beans that are carrying the same data access code, and they could be accessing different portions of the database concurrently, resulting in exploitation of parallelism and reducing the latency for the business logic to get all the data it needs from the database in order to do its work.